Hey everybody, it's another coffee break with Sean. It's been a few months since I've done one of these. Last few months have been challenging. We have 3 children and 2 working spouses. I'm sure most of you are in a similar position. So the stress level has been high. It's been relatively manageable, but I'm glad we're getting into not a new normal, but enough hands have played out of this event that we're getting into a rhythm again. Let's call it that. So a lot of folks haven't asked me what my thoughts are in the future. And I like to sort of preface that about I can't give you what I don't have, which is a crystal ball, and I can only take you as far as I've been, which is pretty much in the present and in the past. If I had to sum up my what financial planning is in 2 sentences, it would be: humans share a highly correlated path. We each have unique experiences, limitations, but at its core, the milestones and forks in the road are relatively the same. Advisors are a guide and a curator to the next life stage. Think of us as Sherpas, but we have limitations. My value isn't fancy marketing using a program to calculate your financial plan. My value is experience. I've worked with folks at all life cycles from start to finish and anywhere in between. And why do I bring this up? Well, because we really don't know what the pandemic effects will be long term. Will the government have to increase taxes to pay for all these different programs that have taken place? Yes. What does that mean for IRAs? It probably is going to mean they're less productive. Does that mean that Roth IRAs are the way to go because of backdoor Roths and Roth contributions? Probably, but we don't really know. We don't know how far societal changes, which have come up in the last couple of months, are going to take place and close loopholes and potentially hurt the prospects of saving effectively for retirement. Another conversation would be about in a macro is that we incur a lot of debt, and what's going to happen to our currency? Well, I would say probably in the long term, there's going to be an event that our currency is devalued. So what we're telling our clients is we can't control this. It's an unknown unknown. Societal change is unknown unknown. A pandemic is a known unknown. We know it was going to happen. We don't know when it was going to happen. So the unknown unknown, how do you defend against that? It's something similar to our bucket two strategy. We're building enough of a runway to allow enough time to get by so you're not panicking. And the same thing goes with the current event. I have that bucket two, which is a 3 to 6 months of planning of savings. And then have 2 to 3 months of non-durable goods in, such as toilet paper, canned goods, things like that. Don't go crazy and buy 20 years worth because it's going to get expired and turn worthless. Buy enough that you can consume it before the expiration, but that if there's shortages, you're not out there flooding the crowds looking for a roll of toilet paper. Same thing goes with durable goods. A lot of things are on sale right now. If you see a discount, go for it. So in summation, we really don't know. I have no clue what's going to happen tomorrow. All I can do is create strategies to help maximize the new world that will exist in the future, and to prevent you from having a panic attack when things go bad. The last sort of comment I would put out there is that in 2015, Mount Everest had that terrible earthquake, and landslides took out a lot of the old paths, and the maps were no longer valid. But the Sherpas, what I quit advising to earlier, were still hired. And the reason for that wasn't because they just were in a habit of hiring them. It's because they still had the technical experience. They still had a general idea of the landscape was, of what the future was going to hold. So same thing goes with financial planning. When you hire a financial planner, we don't know what tomorrow will bring, but we have the ability to maximize the utility of the dollars you have for the future. So until next time, thank you. Bye-bye.